Jr.'s 85th birthday was Wednesday. The federal holiday honoring the slain civil rights leader is held each year on the third Monday of January, which is next week. WDSU's Quaylen Murphy has a look at what several local universities are doing to celebrate.
A drum major is a leader that keeps the rhythm and the beat of time. Starting Friday, four local universities will get together to celebrate one of the great humanitarian drum majors in history.
Dillard, Loyola, Tulane, and Xavier Universities have shared a community-wide Martin Luther King Jr. Week for Peace for nearly 30 years. In many ways, it's a symbolic partnership.
I think, too, because you have two predominantly white institutions and two HBCUs working together as well, that sort of really embodies a lot of what Dr. King talked about.
One day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
This year's four-day celebration of King's life and legacy starts Friday and will kick off with a step show and talent show at Tulane University.
On Saturday, Loyola will be hosting the MLK Convocation, and our guest speaker is Minnie Jean Brown Trickey of the Little Rock Nine, and so she'll be coming and delivering a keynote entitled 50 Years Later, MLK's Dream Revisited.
I was president of an institution that was literally 1 mile down the street from Central High School. And so a lot of the work that I did and some of the things that we did with the mission of Philander Smith College was based on the work of the Little Rock Nine.
Activities will continue at Dillard University on Sunday with an interfaith service, including scripture readings and combined choir performances. The four-day celebration will conclude Monday with a day of service.
This is always the highlight of the week, and it's a lot of fun, and particularly for our Loyola students, it really means a lot because it ties back into our Jesuit identity.
We're going to be going out into the community not as a Loyola student, not as a Dillard student or a Tulane student, but as college students from across New Orleans, and I just think that's amazing.
The dream is sort of like what Ignatius Loyola presented to us and the Jesuits, this dream, this vision of what this country could be like, what things should be like, and we want to go back and revisit that 50 years later.
A time for reflection, appreciation, and a chance to establish a bigger vision. For WDSU, I'm meteorologist Quaylen Murphy.
Martin Luther King Jr. Day was created in 1983 when President Ronald Reagan signed it into law despite opposition. The holiday was officially observed in 50 states for the first time in 2000.